Hola de nuevo, YouTube. We are here with the full tutorial to show how to create our newest Willy's Wonderland character that we made. Of course, you might have seen the short teaser on this channel already. We do those before every full creation. And today, that's going to be Tito the Turtle. So, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to start off with a Mecha as our source object right here. Take off all that stuff that you saw, almost all of the limbs, just kind of left the thigh, if you could call it that, you know, that upper leg part. And then grab that thigh of the Archaeopteryx right there. We showed how to spell that on screen, and we're going to be doing that twice, actually, but we want to kind of wait before we start editing more of the body, I guess. Sometimes order can play a huge part. By order, I mean like the order that you're putting your stamps down in. A mutant, that was the back arm piece after we just did arm, you know, and that's we're starting off the legs right now. Hydra is going to be the next one. Take the, there's like a back foot in the back. Does that make sense? So the behind foot in the back. Anyway, the Mecha has sort of two moving parts for its legs, and so with that you can kind of put the pants on one part and then the foot on the other. You know, where the Mecha's foot is, put Tito's foot. That'll separate it out correctly. Dog tail. You saw that we put the other Archaeopteryx thigh. That's, we've now created his shell, but sort of on the outer edges, you could say. There's like the ridges of the shell, and that's what the dog tail was for. We got a squid. There's like a tentacle piece that's just essentially one long black line like that. If you grab that, we can make all of the little lines of the shell, give it that detail. Mutant back arm piece, once again, can now actually be the arms for Tito, at least the clothing. And then we got claws coming up in there, and we're going to talk about some things in 1 second. I kind of already know what everybody's thinking, but here, let's finish out the creation of the body first. Cuttlefish, take this tentacle piece that's sort of in the middle. It's like the arm tentacle. Tendril, I guess. There's a part of it just on the end. Looks like a triangle like that. And so the reason that we have that down in there, you can see I'm sort of sizing it up and down. That's because you can only move it like a certain degree outside of the boundaries of whichever grid you're placing it on. But there's one part of the claws that doesn't look like it actually has the like fingernail, the claw within it. So that's why we took that cuttlefish piece. Ladies and gentlemen, we're now finally able to move on to the properties editor, and that's where you can edit the health. You can make what your character sounds like, you know, if you want it to have a certain sound whenever it speaks or does whatever. This is where I like to read background information and fun facts about the characters that we create. Let's do this. The animatronic turtle from Willy's Wonderland, Tito.
Bienvenidos.
Yeah, he's one of the possessed antagonists of the movie,
and he speaks in Espanol.
He's got a Spanish accent and all that, voiced by the same person who voices Ozzy Ostrich in the film. Hey, we made Ozzy in the last creation episode. Check that one out if you haven't. But we've created our turtle friend here today, essentially as he can be seen in daylight lighting. All right, not a huge controversy, but there was some discussion on his turtle skin color in my short preview episode. You know, we do the speed create teaser videos less than a minute long before we sit down and learn how to create these characters tutorial style. Anyway, some people noted his skin is supposed to be more blue, which is true when we look at the poster design, and it would actually be highly saturated blue then. But look at video or images like this of him outside, and that skin color actually looks pretty washed out, almost more greenish like my creation. I'll show off and discuss this later so that we can actually see what it looks like with a more blue color as well in Scribblenauts. So let's examine it then. Thanks again to everyone. Please subscribe only if you like this kind of stuff. Not looking for empty subscribes. Any character creation content, it appears here. So you saw, after making now a head as our source object with bubble down there, we're gonna start off the eyes with this, but we're also gonna kind of do that turtle beak, you could call it, you know, his mouth. That area is gonna be a mola, so the mola is like a fish, the ocean sunfish, and comb over right now can be for the eyebrows. So you can already see it sort of starting to take form. Take that look of his head. We are creating them separately here in Scribblenauts Unlimited because there is a limit to how many stamps you can put on. I know, I just said the game's name is Scribblenauts Unlimited. Well, they do have limits. It's kind of surprising, right? So a worm middle body piece, that's that goatee down there. And we're going to have this Spanish mustache with the octopus. So octopus, there's like a tentacle piece that's just has a slight bend on it in there. And hopefully you saw on screen which one we just took, because a moon is going down now, and that's going to start off his sombrero. You know, it's like you could just type that in and it would not look as accurate. It's that's always my philosophy in this game, is like, how can we think outside of the box and creatively to get the stamp required for what we're trying to create? And so in this case, to make it accurately, actually, we can do it this way. A hemisphere is going down for those eyelids. That's just going to start off the eyes because we're going to do a sphere right underneath that. You can see the white of the eyes getting made right here. Looking good. We're almost done. So let's do a golf ball. That'll be for the iris. You know, this colored part of his eyes going down right now. And for the inner, we'll do the pupil, I guess, as a wart. And that'll be paints it all the way black right here, but we can also use the wart for some of the design on the hat. There are a lot more emblems and things on the hat, but we would run out of stamp space before we could get them all, so it would look kind of bad if we just included, like, say, one instead of having it all the way around the hat and making it more decorative like that. So here, Tito head, we've named it, and when you're going into the properties editor on your head object, if you are creating them separately, please don't skip this step. Under the equipment tab, fill in the circle near the bottom that says can be worn on the face like glasses. You'll see in a second why we do that, but first let's go ahead and analyze this turtle skin color. So here you can see on the left, that's to our left, there's a Tito that I've created with more blue skin, and of course our Tito on the right that we've just been editing, and then look of course at this screenshot in the middle of Tito from the movie, and so that's actually taken from the movie. He's outdoors right there, certainly a little bit more kind of like beat up, been through some scuffles, and notice that our creation on the right fits that a lot better. If we were going to be making the poster version cartoony, just like our Willy Weasel, it would be colored differently as well as appear differently too. The poster graphics are not, you know, spitting images of what their main in real life quote unquote characters look like. I've been through this one too many times, man. My channel grew with FNAF, and that audience, they would nitpick every single little thing. So this ain't my first rodeo. We've got the head off of our body object right now. All we need to do is just put the head object into the hands of our body object. You know, you're gonna give it to it. And notice that that's actually pretty close. You know, we don't really have to make too many edits, and that's great. Sometimes it'll just be like way off. So we'll go back into the object editor, edit our body object right here. Move that green grid where the head is supposed to go, wherever you kind of need it to be. In the case of our Tito creation, we just needed to move the head forward only a slight bit. You can see what it looks like on screen. I think it would be best to see our Tito creation in action right now. We're gonna take out this shotgun. We've scripted it basically to destroy weapons. That was kind of like as close. Maybe he could just follow somebody with a weapon. I don't know. I think that was better. I mean, it's like, it's supposed to be sort of like the movie, not exactly where he stole the shotgun shells. But yeah, there's our Tito creation, man. Great fun. Let's see. Here, we'll battle him. Slightly like the movie. It's actually not really gonna be like the movie because this shotgun, we can't really hit him with it. All right, take it. Dude, oh my gosh, just ow. You see that punch? I'm immortal. It's okay. But you know what? Let's run away. Tito, don't kill me.
Gracias por ver.
Clicking in screen.